In a world where the most violent attacks are inflicted against freedom and against equality, the information and communication industries and technologies use and abuse the image, or what is called image, in a confusing and equivocal manner. When what is shown to us ceases to construct us as freely acting subjects, sharing time and space with a community, I call into question the very notion and term of image as it appears in the field of the audiovisual market that claims to be charged with information, communication, and entertainment. The question I'm asking is about the recognition in each of us of a capacity to produce not only the shared form of reality and figures of memory by expressive and sensible means, but also and above all, to bring forth fictional propositions that, by rejecting the category of the impossible, make the unthought, the unthinkable blossom. This operational capacity is nothing other than the capacity to produce images on the basis of a desiring and creative energy. This is why, rather than continuing to speak of image, I will instead speak of an imaging operation to designate the transformative and emancipatory energy of the creative actions of images. Everyone will agree that to make images is to give form and figures to the past and to construct figures of an imagined, dreaded, or desired future. All these operations arise from and are based in memory or anticipation. Metaphor, allegory, illustrations, and representations are all imagined actions that language can also accomplish. What I'm calling an imaging operation is another productive register, because by it, I mean the apparition of forms in a site of indetermination and in a specific temporality that indiscriminately offers everyone the force to transform the world. This imaging register operates according to a double regime. It grounds the genesis of all subjectivation and presides also over the invention of an egalitarian political life. If images are recognized in their constituent function, it is inevitable that power and the dominant order will want to be guaranteed of their control at the levels of both production and diffusion. Christian thought, the first to be grounded on an imaging operation called incarnation, very quickly wanted to constitute its political power, thereby guaranteeing control over this operation for itself. The definition and preservation of imaging operations are thus directly involved in a political economy of sensible forms. If the image is neither a thing nor an object, but instead an operation, then we must grasp its two registers of efficiency. We must understand that, on the one hand, its sensible presence operates as an action able to make a singular space arise within a singular temporality, and that, on the other hand, it is an active process in the field of operation in the combative sense of this term. An imaging operation for me is a guerrilla operation inscribed in a battlefield confronting a constituted reality. This reality of dominant apparatuses is the stop block against which the imaging operations that I call constituent fictions exert themselves. Their power is grounded on their indifference to all occupation of power and space, and on their ability to demolish every reign. Therefore, my hypothesis is that imaging operations place every regime of territorial occupation and of regime of disjunction into crisis.